ఆమేన్.
త్రికాల జపము. ఏలిన వారి సన్మనస్కుడు మరియమ్మతో మంగళవార్త చెప్పెను. దీరపు సాదం చేత ఆయన మరియమ్మ వందనము. ఏలిన వారు మీతో ఉన్నారు. స్త్రీలలో ఆశీర్వదింపబడిన వారు మీరే. మీ గర్భఫలముకు జయస్సు. ఆశీర్వదింపబడిన వారు అగునే.
పరిశుద్ధ మరియమ్మ శ్రేయస్సులైన మాత పాపాత్మీయుల
ఇదిగో ఏలిన వారి దాసిరాలను.
మీ మాట చెప్పినాక జరుగుగాక.
దేరపు సాదం చేత ఆయన మరియమ్మ వందనము. ఏలిన వారు మీతో ఉన్నారు. స్త్రీలలో ఆశీర్వదింపబడిన వారు మీరే. మీ గర్భఫలముకు జయస్సు. ఆశీర్వదింపబడిన వారు అగునే.
పరిశుద్ధ మరియమ్మ సర్వేశ్వరుని ఏక మాత పాపాత్మీయుడు మా కొరకు ఎప్పుడైనా మా మరణాసన దినము ప్రార్థించండి. ఆమేన్.
పుత్రుడైన సర్వేశ్వరుడు మనుషోతారం ఎత్తెను.
మరియమ్మతో కూడా వాసమయుండెను.
దేరపు సాదం చేత ఆండిన మరియమ్మ వందనము. ఏలిన వారు మీతో ఉన్నారు. స్త్రీలు ఆశీర్వదింపడిన వారు మీరే. మీ గర్భఫలముకు జయస్సు. ఆశీర్వదింపడిన వారు అగునే.
పరిశుద్ధ మరియమ్మ సర్వేశ్వరుని ఏక మాత పాపాత్మీయుడు మా కొరకు ఎప్పుడైనా మరణాసనము ప్రార్థించండి. ఆమేన్.
యేసు క్రీస్తు నాదిని దివ్య వాగ్దత్తములకు మేము పాత్రలు మగనట్లు ప్రార్థించుదము. సర్వేశ్వర స్వామి, సన్మస్కుడు చెప్పినందువలన మీ పుత్రుడైన యేసు క్రీస్తుని మనుషోతారం తెలుసుకుంటిమి. అతని పాటల వలన స్లీవ వలను ఉత్నమేక మహిమ మేము పొందినట్లు మాకు మీ వరప్రసాదములను దయచేయవలనని దేవర వారిని వేడుకొనుచున్నాము. యేసు క్రీస్తునాథుని దివ్య ముఖమును చూచి ఈ మనలను మాకు దయచేయండి.
ఆమేన్.
ఉదయకాల సమర్పణ. ఓ నా యేసువ, ఈ దినము నేను చెప్పు జపములను, చేయి పనులను, పడు కష్టములను, పొందు సంతోషములను, నా పాపముల పరిహారమునకును, సమస్త సభికుల ఉద్దేశముల కొరకును, మీకు ఎడతెగక పూజాబలిలోను అప్పగించే ఉద్దేశములతో వీని నేకీభవించి మరియమ్మ గారి నిష్కలంక హృదయ మూలముగా మీకు సమర్పిస్తున్నాను. మరియు విశేషంగా పరిశుద్ధ పాపు గారు ఈ నెలకు నియమించిన పొత్తు తలంపు కొరకు, ప్రత్యేక తలంపు కొరకు పై సత్కార్యములను మీకు సమర్పిస్తున్నాను. పరిశుద్ధ కన్య మరియమ్మ, సర్వేశ్వరుని మాత, మీకు నన్ను సమర్పించుకొనిచున్నాను. మీ బిడ్డగా నన్ను కాపాడండి. ఈ దినం ఏ పాపంలో పడకుండా నా కొరకు ప్రార్థించండి. దైవ కృపచేత నాకు కావలిగా నిండి సన్మనస్కుడా, నాకు ఈ దినము జ్ఞాన వెలుతురునిచ్చి కాపాడి నడిపించండి. ఆమేన్. ప్రాతకాల ప్రార్థన. స్వయంభూ అనాది అశరీరిమితి లేని సకల మేలుల స్వరూపి, జ్ఞానము బలిమి కారణముల చేత సర్వవ్యాప్తి, సర్వమునకు మూల కారణమైన పితా పుత్ర పవిత్రాత్మయనుడు ఏకతీత్వ సర్వేశ్వర, మేము ఆరాధిస్తున్నాము. మితిలేని స్తోత్రమునకు పొగడింపునకు మహిమకు తగిన వారు మీరే. దయా సముద్రమైండెడు సర్వేశ్వరుడు మనకు చేసిన ఉపకారం తలంచి మేలెరిగిన స్తోత్రము చేయుదుముగాక. సర్వేశ్వర, తమరు నా ఆత్మ శరీరములను ఏమి లేమి నుండి సృష్టించి నేను బ్రతుకుటకు లెక్కలేని ఉపకారములు చేసి తిరే.
స్వామి మీకే స్తోత్రం కలుగును గాక.
దేవా, ఈ రాత్రి యందు ఒక్క అపాయమైనను కలగకుండా నన్ను కాపాడి తిరే.
స్వామి మీకే స్తోత్రం కలుగును
గాక. దేవా, జ్ఞానస్థానం ద్వారా నన్ను తిరుసభలో చేర్చి మీ బిడ్డనుగా చేసుకుని జేసు పవిత్ర మరణం చేత లభించిన మితిలేని ఫలములకు నన్ను భాగస్థునిగా చేయనవదరించి తిరే.
స్వామి మీకే స్తోత్రం కలుగును గాక.
దేవా, నా పాప కార్యములకు నన్ను నరకమున త్రోసివేయక పాప సంకీర్తనం ద్వారా నన్ను ఓదార్చి నాకు సప్రసాదమైన దివ్య భోజనం ప్రసాదింపనవదరించి తిరే.
స్వామి మీకే స్తోత్రం కలుగును గాక.
దేవా, నేను ఎన్నియో ద్రోహములు చేసినను తల్లిదండ్రుల వలె నన్ను కాపాడి తిరే.
స్వామి మీకే స్తోత్రం కలుగును గాక.
సర్వేశ్వర, మీ ఏకైక కుమారుడైన జేసునాథుడు నా కొరకు అనేక పాటలు అనుభవించి స్లీవ మీద కఠినమైన మరణము పొంద తమరు చిత్తగించి తిరే.
స్వామి మీకే స్తోత్రం కలుగును గాక.
సర్వేశ్వర, మీరు ఆనతిచ్చిన ఆజ్ఞల ప్రకారం యోగినిగా ప్రవర్తించదనని దృఢ ప్రతిజ్ఞ చేయుచున్నాను. నా తలంపు వాక్కు క్రియలను ఆత్మ శరీరములను మీ సేవకు తగినట్టు నడిపించుకున్నటకు మీకు వశపరుస్తున్నాను. నేను చేసే సత్క్రియలన్నింటినీ జేసునాథుని పుణ్యఫలములతో దేవర వారు చేకొనండి. వాని వలన వచ్చే జ్ఞాన ఫలములను పొంది నా పాపముల కొరకు ఉత్తరింప మనస్సుగానున్నాను. ఆమేన్. ఈ దినము మనకి ఎలాంటి కీడు రాకుండా సర్వేశ్వరుని వేడుకొందుము. సకల కీడుల నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
సకల పాపముల నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
మీ కోపాగ్ని నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
ఆకస్మికమైన ఆయత్తము లేని మరణము నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
పిచాచి తంత్రముల నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
కోపము పగ మొదలైన దుర్గుణముల నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
మోహాగ్ని నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
పిడుగులు గోర గాలి మొదలైన వాని నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
భూకంపము నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
అంటు రోగము కరువు యుద్ధము మొదలైన వాని నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
నిత్య మరణము నుండి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి మనుషోతార పరమ రహస్యమును చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి ఆగమనమును చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి జన్మమును చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి తపోస్థానము ఉపవాసమును చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి స్లీవ పాటులను చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి మరణమును భూస్థాపనమును చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి పరిశుద్ధ శరీర ఉత్థానమును చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవర వారి మహిమ ప్రతాపం గల మోక్షారోహణమును చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
ఓదార్చడు పవిత్రాత్మ యొక్క రాకడను చూచి
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
న్యాయ నిర్ణయము జరిగేడి దినములలో
మమ్మ రక్షించండి స్వామి.
దేవమాత శరణగోరు జపము. మిక్కిలిన తల్లి సహాయములను అడిగిన వారిలో ఒక్కరైనను మీ వలన చేయబడినట్లు ఎన్నడు లోకములో వినదలేని తల్లి, ఇటువంటి నమ్మిక చేత ప్రేరేపింపబడి మీ పవిత్ర పాదములను సమీపించి వచ్చి ఉన్నాను. నిట్టూర్పు విడిచి విలాపించి ఏడ్చడు పాపి అయిన నేను మీ దయాలమునకు కాచుకుని మీ సమకములో నిలుస్తున్నాను. దేవునికి ప్రియమైన కుమార్తెగా నుండు కన్య మరియమ్మ పుత్రుడైన సర్వేశ్వరునికి పరిశుద్ధ తల్లి అయిన కన్య మరియమ్మ
దేవ నంబిక పుణ్యవర్తికెనట్లా మీ దివ్య కుమారుని వేడుకొనండి.
పవిత్రాత్మైన సర్వేశ్వరునికి మిక్కిలి ప్రియురాయలైన కన్య మరియమ్మ జన్మ పాపం లేక ఉద్భవించిన పరిశుద్ధ మరియమ్మ పాపుల శరణమా, ఇదిగో పరిగెత్తి వచ్చి మీ శరణ వచ్చి తిని
వేడుకొనండి.
పరిశుద్ధ మరియమ్మ, ఈ దినము నేను అనేక సత్క్రియలను చేయునట్టుగాను నా యందుగల దుర్గుణములను అణచునట్టుగాను విరక్తత్వమునకు విరుద్ధమైన పాపములను కట్టుకొనకుండునట్టుగాను మిమ్ము మనవి చేయుచున్నాను. పునీత జోజప్ప, మీరు బాలయేసును అనేక శరీర ఆపదల నుండి కాపాడినట్టు నన్ను ఆత్మ శరీర కీడుల నుండి కాపాడవలనని మనవి చేయుచున్నాను. నా కావలి అయిన సన్మన్స్ కూడా దైవ కృపచేత మీకు అప్పగింపబడిన నన్ను ఈ దినము పిచాచి యొక్క శోధనలో పడనివ్వక కాపాడి పుణ్య మార్గంలో నడిపించవలనని మిమ్మల్ని మనవి చేయుచున్నాను. నా పాలక పునీతులారా, మీ వలే నేను ఈ భూలోకంలో సర్వేశ్వరుని తెలుసుకొని ప్రేమించి సేవించినట్టు మిమ్ము మనవి చేయుచున్నాను. సకల పునీతులారా, మీతో సర్వేశ్వరుని పరలోకంలో దర్శించి స్తుతింప దైవ కృప నాకు దొరుకునట్టు మనవి చేయుచున్నాను. సర్వశక్తుడును దయాపరుడైన పితా పుత్ర పవిత్రాత్మయనుడు ఏకతీర్థ సర్వేశ్వరుడు మనను ఆశీర్వదించి కాపాడునుగాక.
ఆమేన్.
A 76. Out of our darkness, O Jesus Christ, we call to you before day starts. Let your light shine on us today. Remain with us till shadows fall. For rising sun, resplendors of the Father, Jesus Christ, we sing to you. The way of life that leads us to the kingdom, with one heart we sing your praise. Out of our darkness, O Jesus Christ, we call to you before day starts. Let your light shine on us today. Remain with us till shadows fall.
God led her and taught her and kept her as the apple of his eye, like an eagle spreading wings. God alone her guide. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of the Lord, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
It was the 9th child, and Louis, the orphan children, died, and the 4 were given or offered to the Lord to serve, and the youngest was Saint Teresa, who was beautiful in her appearance, and at the age of 15 she wanted to join the Carmelites and remain an offered nun for the entire life, and that was her desire. And the rule of the congregation was to take any candidate at the age of 21. Since she was not having the sufficient age, the congregation denied the admittance. And it so happened, her father was going to Rome, and she, together with her parent, the dad, she went and approached and requested the Pope then. And it was the approval of Pope which made her to enter the congregation of Carmelites. And at that tender age, she was determined to stay stern in her vocation. And her father was paralyzed, and that was another ache and the pain to her. And yet, she did not give up the call and the perseverant life that she wanted. And she remained and led a sanctifying life and offered herself as a tender flower. And it was at the age of 26 she lost her life from ill health. At young age she joined, and at very young age she lost her life. And yet she remained one of the strongest and evident leader and the doctor of the church, for having worked and given her life offered in the congregation of Carmelite. And let us all take her example. And she was called also the little flower, and we have several institutes named after, and most popular name among the institutes. And we have in our own diocese, the Diocese Institute Little Flower at Nagar Karnool, and also we have Little Flower Institutes in Nalgonda. And let us all pray for them and all those who are working there and who are being the beneficiaries of the institutes. Let us pray that this example of Saint Teresa, who was working a little things in a great manner, let us for a while seeking and offering all what we wanted to. Place also those who are intending to take the example of Saint Teresa, doing small things in a great manner. Let us also offer for one of the devotees who seeks the prayers of Our Lady and of Saint Teresa today, and also for the souls of Balla Julenaya and Mariamma. Before we take part this Holy Eucharist, let us call to our minds the sins and the failures. I confess to Almighty God.
Unto my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned through my faults,
in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous faults.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, unto you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God.
VG1, page 351. Sing to God a song of glory. Peace he brings to people on earth. Worship ye the King of heaven. Praise and bless his holy name. Glory, glory, sing his glory. Glory to our God on high. Sing to Christ the Father's loud one. Jesus, Lord and Lamb of God, hear our prayer, O Lord, have mercy. You who bear the sin of all, glory, glory, sing his glory. Glory to our God on high. Sing to Christ the Father's love. Seated there at God's right hand, hear our prayer, O Lord, have mercy. You alone, the Holy One, glory, glory, sing his glory. Glory to our God on high. Glory sing to God the Father. Glory to his only Son. Glory to the Holy Spirit. Glory to the Three in One. Glory, glory, sing his glory. Glory to our God on high.
Let us also remember the soul of Sarah during this Holy Eucharist. Let us pray. O God, who open your kingdom to those who are humble and to little ones, lead us to follow trustingly in the little way of Saint Teresa, so that through her intercession we may see your eternal glory revealed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You, my friends, for the hand of God has struck me. Why do you hunt me down like God? With your never have enough for my flesh. Oh, would that these words of mine were written down, inscribed on some monument with iron chase and engraving tools, cut into the rock forever. This I know, that my average lives, and he the lost will take his stand on earth. After my awaking, he will set me close to him, and from my flesh I shall look on God. He whom I shall see will take my part. These eyes will gaze on him and find him not aloof. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response. I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living.
O Lord, hear my voice when I call, have mercy and answer. Of you my heart has spoken, seek his face. A response.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living.
It is your face, O Lord, and that I seek. Hide not your face. Dismiss not your servants in anger. You have been my help. A response.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living.
Hope in him, hold firm and take heart, hope in the Lord. A response.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living.
Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 10, verses from 1 to 12. The Lord appointed 72 others and sent them out ahead of him in pairs in all the towns and places he himself was to visit. He asked them, "The harvest is rich, but the laborers are few. So ask the Lord of the harvest to send laborers to his harvest. Start off now, but remember, I am sending you out like lambs among wolves. Carry no purse, no haversack, no sandals. Salute no one on the road. Whatever house you go in, let your first words be, 'Peace to this house.' And if a man of peace lives there, your peace will go and rest on him. If not, it will come back to you. Stay in the same house, taking what food and drink they have to offer, for the laborer deserves his wages. Do not move from house to house. Whenever you go into a town where they make your home welcome, eat what is set before you. Cure those in it who are sick and say, 'The kingdom of God is very near to you.' But whenever you enter a town and they do not make you welcome, go out into its streets and say, 'We wipe off the very dust of your town that clings to our feet and leave it with you. Get sure of this, the kingdom of God is very near. I tell you, on that day, it will not go as hard with Sodom as with that town." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is important to not only to know the fruit, but the cause of the fruit, that is tree. If we want a good fruit, we do take or nurture the very plant or tree. We cannot dream about a good fruit taking no care of the tree. And that is what is to be celebrated today. The tree, the causes of someone to be offered to the church. Martin and Louis, the parents of St. Teresa, who offered 5 of their children to the Lord's service. And the last among them was St. Teresa. And there are good number of parents known to us as well who were eager and who were ready to offer their children to the serve the Lord, either as priests or nuns or in various forms. And it was not merely sending them to become a nun or priest, but what the example they had to offer to their own children was more important, and that was the great thing which the parents of Saint Teresa had done, not only to her but to the latter generations. To offer to God itself was a great thought, and to lead a life that was very prayerful, inspiring to their own children to live close to the God in imitation as received occasion was another honor. And that was the pride that the parents of Saint Teresa had, and we all have to look up to them, and they are the trees who offered great fruits to the Catholic Church. And let us also thank God for all the parents who offered their own children, not to take care of their own selves, but to the souls who are going astray from the Lord's path. So they had the desire to spread, and this is one way of spreading the word of God. And that was another act of mission. Not everyone could go, but we can prepare someone and offer someone to the Lord to go out and to proclaim. An indirect proclamation was done by the parents of Saint Teresa, not sending one but many of their own children. Unfortunately, the living, apart from those who went to serve God, were died. Yet the faith of these parents are to be honored, remembered, and to be proclaimed greatly even today. And let us also remember and pray for those parents who have offered their children. At times there are only one or two, and both were sent. And the sacrifice of their parents is to be admired and appreciated, and they should be saluted. This is one aspect of the life of Saint Teresa. And not that she had a good parenting and all that, but she did live and continue the life that she adopted from the parents. We all have Mary and Joseph, who were prayerful, who were God-fearing, and had Jesus amongst their own selves. And we all take the example of the Holy Family. Parents do play a great role in upbringing of the children, and the effect is in the form of Saint Teresa, whom we see today, not doing great things and wonders, but doing the little things in a great manner. That is the simple and the best example which Saint Teresa offers us today. Not that we should be given a great response and great honor and a great chair. The little that you do, which is not noticed, and that was noticed only by the Lord. What God sees is your heart, and that's what is said, and that was evident in the life of Saint Teresa. She was a Carmelite, as we all know. The life was not going out and doing social work or proclaiming and preaching and all that. Nothing is exhibited to the world outside. We never go in and see what they do. She was just inside and hardly lived 10 or 11 years. And yet, she is said to be the strongest, one of the strongest saints of this era, because 1917, where she passed away. And that was the life. Not that someone has to see, but the Lord should see your little things. A little thing make wonder, provided we have the attitude that the Lord sees my work. He knows what my thoughts are. And let us offer all this. That is the reason the little flower was offered in a great big manner, but doing the little things in a great manner. Let this line get into our own minds today, so that all that we do, all that we think, all that we plan to do, may be little things, unnoticed, yet let us do it in a big manner. All the apostles are not known much. Even there are so many saints whom we never remember. We see people in terms of order, priority, hierarchy, and of importance, while God does not see. He places everyone equally in His presence. We have in our own mind the priorities according to their need, status, and various reasons, while God does not. And she did live a life which is not noticed, yet God had seen the greatness and the virtue of her life. And the sanctity has been uplifted to the extent of sainthood within no time, and she was said to be one of the doctors contributing great things to the church. And let us all pray for one another for this great reason of what we are supposed to. And as we have already read in the gospel, that all those who are called are sent. 72 of them were sent, and they were asked to do to give peace. Wherever you go, you say, peace be to you. And this was, and which we all today also are supposed to be carrying that on our shoulders. Priests, nuns, all those who are called, supposed to be the peace givers. We are supposed to offer peace wherever we go, to a house or a town, where we are supposed to be giving peace. Yesterday I was telling someone about, we are not supposed to be the people who are causing separation. A priest cannot cause a separation. He should work only for unity. And that is what is the call that we have given. And she prayed and worked for the same purpose. Let St. Teresa give that example once again. Not only priests or whoever, all of us are called to Christian and Catholic life only to work for peace. Because he had come to bring peace between man and God. The relationship was broken, and it was Jesus who came down. By offering himself, he brought peace. And that is the reason we all read at the time of his death on the Calvary, the path, the curtain is all torn. The division between God and the man made visible, and again it is reconnected and rebuilt. Let us pray for one another that the Lord and our own prayers would certainly bring peace and unity among us. Let us offer all our families, all our communities, all the institutes, all the parents, and all, everywhere, the Christian family is to work for peace and unity. Let us, as parents and all those who are called, live an example, just like the parents of St. Teresa, who not only offered, but lived a life that was spiritually inspiring for the children or the procreation. Let us pray also for all who are carried away with so many things in this world today, and parenting has to be very strong, and they need to be also very sincere. A bad parent and with various bad habits cannot give a best example to their own children. And parent is also to be very God-fearing, unless if they want to give a good guidelines to their own children. Let us pray also for parents and children who are carried away with a bad example of the parents, and there is no control on their own children. So let us arise and pray. In a special way, for all the institutes that are working in our diocese, in the name of Little Flower, taking the example of St. Teresa. Let us offer the intentions of the faithful who are offering the Mass today. Let us offer also the souls of Julianaya and Mariamma, and also Sara Rohini.
B39. Yours as we stand at the table, you say. Yours as we eat the bread, our hearts can't forget. We are the signs of your life with us. We are yours, we are yours. Take a bread, we ask you, take a heart. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours, we are yours. Your holy people stand vast in your blood. Spirit filled yet hungry, we await your food. Poor though we have brought ourselves to you. We are yours, we are yours. Take a bread, we ask you, take a heart. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours, we are yours. Yours as we stand at the table, you say. Yours as we eat the bread, our hearts can't forget. We are the signs of your life with us. We are yours, we are yours.
Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
God our Father, we offer together with this bread and wine the children who have gone astray, walking away from your path. May the intercession of Saint Teresa assist us and help us, that we might be back unto your fold, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. It is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with the angels, archangels, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of blood, the blood of the eternal covenant, which is me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, wonder of resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed us to reconcile to self, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he, so that chain the with Saint Teresa of Lisieux and all the saints on whose failing health. Lord, advance, be pleased to confirm with your Listen graciously to the prayers of the family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful, gather to yourself all your children. Let us offer the intentions of those who offer Mass today. We remember our departed brothers and sisters, namely Julenaya, Mariamma, and Sara Rohini, and all who were pleasing to you in their passing from this. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us all pray to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Father in heaven,
holy be your name.
Your kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in
heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those
against us.
Lead us not into temptation,
but
deliver us
from evil. Let us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously, with your mercy, we may be freed from sin and saved from all distress. Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Turn our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Here is the Lamb who delivers us all from every evil. Happy are we who have come to the banquet of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Sanctify my breast, body of Christ, be thou my saving grace. Blood of my Savior, bathe me in thy tide. Wash me with waters flowing from thy side. Strength and protection, may thy passion be. O blessed Jesus, hear and answer me. Deep in thy wounds, Lord, hide and shelter me. So shall I never part from thee. Guard and defend me from the foe, my life. In desperate moments, make me only thine. Call me and bid me come to thee on high, where I may praise thee with thy saints
forever. Thus says the Lord, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord, kindle in us the force of that love with which Saint Teresa dedicated herself to you and longed to obtain your mercy for all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in peace and love one another.
Thanks be to God. Acts 19. Go, the mercy send there, children of the Lord. Take His word to others. As you heard it spoken to you, go the mercy sending, go and tell the world. The Lord is good, the Lord is kind, and He loves everyone. Go the mercy sending, take His love to all. Gladden all who meet you, fill their hearts with hope and courage. Go the masses sending, fill the world with love, and give to all what you receive, the peace and joy of Christ. Let us pray for our Pope Francis and our parish priest, and pray for our personal intentions and those who asked our prayers. Let us pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us
from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O most sacred heart of Jesus.
Amasianus.
O most sacred heart of Jesus.
Amasianus.
O most sacred heart of Jesus.
Amasianus.
Mary our mother.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Francis.
Pray for us.
All the saints.
Pray for us.
Our guardian angels.
Watch over us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.